Melissa?
I am.
Hi, Melissa. I'm Laura, and I'm here to give you your short game lesson.
Awesome.
All right, so I'm going to ask you a few questions. Can you tell me a little bit about your golf history, how long you play in leagues and stuff like that?
Yep, I've been playing for about 24 years. I play anywhere between 4 and 5 times a week. I do play in a league. My handicap is between 9 and 11, and it fluctuates about that for every season.
Okay.
I'm here because I need to get my handicap down.
Okay, so your big objective, your long term, is to get that handicap down and keep it below the 10. You don't like that double digit.
Right.
You want that single digit.
Yeah.
Okay. How about, did you play any other sports?
Yeah, I was a college athlete. I played softball for 25 years.
Okay.
And I stopped that when I started playing golf.
Okay. So you kind of transitioned into golf, and golf 4 or 5 times is a lot.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so here's a question for you. How often do you get to the range versus that 4 or 5 times playing? Not much.
Not much.
Okay, all right. So you wanted to work on some short game stuff today.
Yeah.
What specifically with some short game? I put some markers out there just so we have a reference, but I want you to tell me something that maybe we can work on specifically in this 30 minutes that you think will help you get that handicap moving lower instead of fluctuating up and down.
Okay, anything that I really don't have to take a full swing with. So inside 50.
Okay, so those in between shots,
yeah,
that you want to get the more consistent, more feel.
Right.
Okay. How about your clubs? Have you been fitted for your clubs?
I was about 2 years ago. I was fully fitted. And
okay, so your new clubs fitted, yep. Comfortable.
Yep. Great.
Clubs are not an issue.
Love them.
Yep. Okay. All right. And this is kind of a weird question because not everyone really knows this, but do you know how you like to learn? Do you like to see things? Do you like to feel things?
I'm more of a
visual
learner. So if you tell me about it and I process, and then if I can watch you, I'll do a lot better.
So if I can demonstrate kind of some of the stuff and you can see it, it'll be able to transition.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. All right, so you were a college athlete, softball. Do you have any injuries related from that or current injuries?
Nope, thank God.
Okay, so nothing we got to worry about today.
Nope.
Swinging the club, getting warm. Okay,
nope.
All right, great.
Nope.
All right, so we will, let's kind of do a dynamic stretch. I know a lot of people think you can just kind of go out and warm up, but the best way to be sure, you can do some motions, and you can just mimic me, basically.
Okay.
And we're going to do some, we'll start doing with some shoulders, and we'll just put the club in front of us and hold it either end, and put it down to our hips, and then reach up and kind of touch our back of our shoulders, and then reach back down. You should kind of feel your shoulders and the back and the upper back stretch.
Oh yeah.
And we'll do that 10 times.
Okay. I definitely gotta spend more time doing this.
Yes, it definitely helps. It just makes that first shot so much better. You know.
Yeah.
You know those days when you say, oh man, I wish I could play the first two holes again?
Yep.
You know, if you hit a few balls and stretched a little bit, let's do one more after this one.
Okay.
It just makes such a difference,
yep.
You know?
Okay.
All right. Okay, so now let's think about the hips and legs. And we can turn this club upside down and hold it kind of like a cane. And you can just swing your leg to where you feel, you know, you can get a stretch. And we'll do both sides. And we'll do 10 again. You ready to switch?
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right, halfway. All right, 10. Okay, now to get your hips and your lower back is we take the club and put it in front of us and kind of get in our posture. And we can just do like a rotation, like we're taking a back swing and a through swing.
Smart.
Yep. And that's halfway, so we'll do 10 as well with this. You feel like you can hit some?
Yep, I sure do.
Okay, so tell me what goes on when you, let me tell you that first of all, we've got 25 yards and 35 yards. Are those kind of in-between numbers that definitely you need to address?
Yeah.
Okay, so You know what we'll do? Let's hit five and set kind of parameters.
Okay.
And then you can tell me if they meet your expectations, okay, or they're outside or they're normal or abnormal.
Okay.
All right. So which one? First of all, which one do you want to go to? The
35.
35. Yep. Okay. So we're going to hit all five of these and I'm going to watch you.
Okay.
And you're looking at landing it as close as possible and staying. You want them to stay. Okay.
Right.
Okay. So of the five, we've got three that went left. They're going the proper distance, but they're going left. We have one that was maybe a little shorter, maybe about 5 yards short. And then the other one was about perfect. Is that about standard?
Yeah.
So you would normally be one out of five, and you're looking at your improvement. You might want to be like 3 out of 5?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Okay.
The ones that go left, that's pretty typical for
that's
me.
That's typical. Okay.
Yeah.
So we're looking at, the distance is pretty good. So part of this. Let me ask this, do you have any alignment sticks in your bag? Do you ever use alignment sticks?
No.
Okay, so this is a great, simple tool, and you don't necessarily need this stick. You can use a club. I happen to have a stick, and I'm gonna, so if we're going at that 35, we want to line it up, and if we have our ball right here, right, in essence, the ball is to my right.
Okay,
correct?
Yeah.
So if I have this stick lined up at my feet, and I'm using it to line up my body, I need this stick to be slightly to the left of the target, right?
Right.
So my body's to the left of that ball, so if I can get back here, and you can get back here on your line, and watch it through that one. Okay. So if I get that on the ball, and I'm kind of, I want to be set. Since you get severely open, you're kind of like this to start with, right? So we kind of almost have to
hit it and go against where my body is.
I have to really extend my arms out here.
And if I
make a good move and kind of follow my shoulders when I'm lined up this much, I'm going to go over there to the left a little, right?
Right. Okay.
So if we can start with just using this alignment stick to remind us of where we want to be,
okay,
right?
Okay.
And again, we can take a club. You can take one of the clubs you're not using and do the same thing,
okay,
right? We can replicate that alignment stick. And just use that and kind of be stacked on this alignment stick, right? And now I don't have to worry about where my arms are because I know that everything is stacked up.
Okay.
On this stick rather than being here and thinking about having to finish against where my body is, right?
Okay.
Alright, so that first example, that's one way to get our ball back online and get it to where we're looking,
okay,
and
so,
where our intention
is. So do not
is.
Open up my body with my weight,
nope,
forward. I've got to be square.
We want to be as square as we can and just have that simple little shot. And so as it naturally finishes along our shoulder line, our shoulders are lined up at our target, and it's going to go right where we're looking.
Okay.
Right? So
okay,
let's do five more,
okay,
with this alignment stick and see if we can get better than that one. All right, that one went right on it.
Yep. That's much better.
Okay, we got two on it. Let's keep building on that.
Short, but online.
Right, so we've got our alignment's improved immensely.
Yes, it's simple. I mean,
right.
I'm like this. Of course,
right.
That doesn't make sense. Okay.
Right. So what you, it
so
seems
that.
because like that might be something you do on just a little chip shot rather than this is a pitch shot, right?
Yeah.
So if we get that bigger swing and it follows completely on our shoulder line, it's going to go left.
Right.
So those aren't necessarily poorly hit shots. They're following your shoulder line.
Okay.
So now we fix that, right?
Right.
And the next thing is they were all a little off on distance wise, right?
Right.
So we want to see a way that if we get lined up right, that we can measure that distance, right?
Right.
And you said you're visual.
Yep.
So one way to do it visually is I measure on my club and you have a logo on your club and I have a logo on my grip, right? We both have logos. So I know that if I'm right here, this is going a certain distance.
Okay.
If I go all the way down here, this is going enough. Because in essence, I've shortened this club, right?
Okay.
So that's one way. And then I go up here and I only choke down this much. See, I'm a little bit above this, but I'm not all the way at the end of the grip.
Right.
So I can measure how far just with a regular swing, right? So if I go here, watch, and I go all the way down to the bottom, right? And just hit, just swing normal, a full swing from there. That goes that distance, right?
Okay.
Now if I go up and I go to where this writing is, see now I've changed it by this much and my writing's there, right?
Okay.
And I do the same normal swing, normal tempo, that went further, right?
Yeah.
And now again, I can go in between from here to here, I can go right here where I got a little bit of a grip down, but I'm not gripped all the way down to the writing, right? And again, it's just that full swing. And I can go, and that's gonna go a little further.
Huh.
So that's one way that you can look down and measure on your club.
Okay.
Right? So let's hit a couple shots. Let's hit three of them.
Okay.
And see where it goes in when you grip down to that V, to your logo on the club.
That's
all right?
Only to there. So now this is going to be a shorter shot. This is going
to
be...
Yeah, let's see if that gets us to our 35. We're trying to find that 35. That's a little chunky. That's all right. We're just gotta. We're gonna take a couple and try and hit them good, and then see if we find that number. That's a little deep. Okay.
That yanked
it. It went. That one went a little left, but that carried the right distance. So. Let's do five of them so we can compare directly and use that as our reference. So we know that that's probably when you hit a regular, a good regular shot, that's going to be your 35 number right there at that little logo.
Awesome.
Uh-oh. All right, let's hit all five of them. Don't worry about one, just one of them. Let's hit all five of them so we can compare. That one carried the exact distance.
Okay.
Right?
Oops. I'm lining up. What's happening?
You feel like you're lined up okay?
I think so.
Okay. There we go.
Okay. But the alignment was good.
You got your alignment. Okay.
I need something different.
Okay, you want something else?
I don't have enough touch.
Okay, all right, so the next, let me get a few more balls out here.
Okay.
And another tip I have for you when you practice, especially for short game, is use balls that you're used to on the course.
Okay,
because range balls aren't going to give you the same feedback.
Okay.
And even if it's you just have 20 balls and you go out and you hit them to a distance and then you go pick them up and bring them back, it's a great way to see where your balls are ending up, to give you that feedback, all right?
Okay,
so here's another way to measure your distance.
Okay.
And this is a little more feel oriented, but if you video yourself, you can see the feedback. And this is, you think of your swing as a clock, okay? So I'm up here and I'm set up at 6 o'clock, right? This club is at 6 o'clock. And I wanna take this, I think about where I wanna take it in the swing. So I wanna take it to 9 o'clock,
okay,
and see how far it goes, right? So I'm just thinking, my hands go to 9 o'clock.
Okay.
Right?
And that was perfect.
That's my number.
Okay.
Now, if I went shorter, we might go over here to this other one. So if I go to 8 o'clock, let's say.
Okay.
Right? And again, that's my 25 yard shot. So then if I go in the same, I'm gripping it in the same place, the same swing tempo, then I go to 10 o'clock, that went further, right?
Right. Yeah, that might work better for me. I just think that I don't know where to stop. You know, I don't know where to stop on my backswing, so that might be good.
All right. Okay, so let's do,
try it.
Let's try five of them.
Okay.
At thinking, let's see if it's 9 o'clock for you.
Okay, so.
Okay, let's see if it's 9 o'clock and let's keep going at that 35 and see if we find something here.
Okay, so 9 o'clock, right there.
Just your hands, yep, just your hands to 9 o'clock. You seem like you're rushing a little bit.
Am I?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, just settle. There's no rush. Yeah, see that was at those last two were the right distance,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So that gives you a sense.
Yeah.
And now if you go down and you can do one a little shorter, do you wanna try a couple to the shorter one?
Yeah, definitely.
So we wanna feel like our hands stay right in front of us and don't quite get to that 9 o'clock. So that means that you don't want your hands all the way to that parallel, right?
Okay. So 8 o'clock, you're thinking it's probably...
Yeah, right in there. A little bit shorter than you had it on the last one.
Okay.
And yeah, now you moved your alignment stick, right?
Yep.
So that's giving you the visual for where you want to line up.
Okay.
There we go.
Yep. Yeah, that definitely gives me a thought process. That's definitely better. A little much.
Okay, that one went a little longer.
Okay.
You can see that it carried further.
Okay.
And you said so yourself, so you got that feedback from yourself. Yep. There we go.
Yeah. And I just feel like I have control over that now, just with that. So, does that work with, like, so I've got a 54, same thing?
Yes, and you just, it's a thing 50,
okay.
Where maybe one of those days a week you come up to the range, and you can just use, I have these old shafts, but you can use a bucket.
Okay.
You can take a couple range buckets
and
walk out there,
okay.
You know, and take your paces, and you can go through all your wedges.
And give
an idea, say like, okay, if I'm just even tempo at 9 o'clock, this is where my 54 goes.
Okay.
If I'm even tempo at what's the loft on this one?
This is 56.
56, this is where my 56 goes.
Okay.
And then at 9 o'clock, and then you can do like a 3/4 swing. So it might be like 10, 10:30, and it's a little, and just have this little range.
Okay.
And again, since you're visual, I would use your alignment stick. And you can use, like I said, if you have a phone and you can set it and film you, you can see and say, okay, I'm gonna hit this club, I'm gonna hit 10 shots and try and hit all to 9 o'clock.
Okay.
And just video yourself and then look back and just see if your hands, so you're getting that visual feedback,
okay.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
So for a long-term thing, if you can come up maybe just once a week and do it, I guarantee that this short game, these in between, if you're a 9 handicap, there's probably, like especially par fives or short par fours,
right.
That you can get at these numbers. And if you don't have
I can't surrender a par because I mishit my second shot. So
right.
That's where this has got
right.
To save me.
Right.
And it's a guessing game at this point. So at least the 8 and the 9 gives
right.
me, the clock gives me a,
it's
know,
a reference.
Concrete something.
Yeah,
that
it's
I
a
can,
reference
yeah.
that you can have that you know that you can commit to a shot on these in-betweens, and that's where that gets a lot of people, you know, a lot of times the in-between But if you can get those in-betweens, and these are shots that you have out on the course, I guarantee if you come up here and spend, even if it's one bucket, or you get a little shag bag again with 20 balls, and you come up here and you do it once a week, you'll see progress.
Awesome.
You know, and I think your handicap will go down. It won't go up to that 11. It'll go in the right direction.
Okay.
All right? So you think that's something you can work on?
Absolutely, yeah.
Get yourself maybe an alignment stick, or remember to use the club, because here you can use it as that visual feedback, and it'll just become memory, muscle memory, and you'll get in there.
Okay.
All right?
Sounds good.
All right.
Definitely.
Good luck with that.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks.